Oh, I like this question. Oh, dear.
I need to sit properly. Sorry. I know you're going to cut all this in where I say, is this right?
My name is Sacha.
I'm Heike Lowenstein.
Alison Taylor.
I'm Jess.
Emily Stokes.
I'm Abbey.
I'm a boat builder and I work
at Wibb Boatyards.
Spirit Yachts.
Raybel.
Alan Staley's Boatyard.
At Spirit Yachts in Ipswich.
I've been a boat builder for 17 years and I run Abbey Boatbuilder, which is my own boatyard.
Raybel is a traditional wooden barge and I'm working on a very specific job over the next 2 months to rebuild the rudder.
So right now I'm working on one of the deep end jibs. I'm just working on small things like fixing the gaff and the floorboards.
Currently working on the first refit that I've worked on.
Well, it's summer, so I try not to do too much work. My winters are really busy and they're intense and I do about 10 to 12 boats on my own. Yeah, I restore old classic boats. Don't care what it is, as long as it's fun.
I'm currently working on a 1940s racing boat called Lassiette. She was built very lightly and she has suffered because of it. She's gone from being that lovely shape to that, and we have brought her back into shape.
Working on currently two different things in the boat. One, the saloon, getting a shelf ready to take an aircon unit, and then also working in the aft cabin heads, which we're getting ready to put the sole board in there and the shower tray.
Now that the majority of the major work has been done, I'm now putting all of the interior back together so that she's usable again, rather than an empty hull.
About this time of year, I start organising winter. So there's Arctic lorries in about 10 different locations all over the country bringing boats up here, and they can't all arrive at the same time, otherwise I fill the village up. So yeah, the logistical nightmare of getting winter organised, and I have to drive all around the country quoting for work.
I like it because it's a very unique boat, like a local boat.
People have a lot invested in this. The people who are involved with this project have been working on it for a long time.
It means a lot to a lot of people around Woodbridge, which is really nice.
What attracted me to it is the size of it. You don't normally have large runners like that.
You know, you move around the boat a lot. You have to go out to go and get your tools, bring them back in. There's people everywhere doing different things. It's good fun. It's like working on a really big 3D jigsaw.
You know, a lot of boat building environments is great up
the
sea.
The most recent project that I worked on, I actually got to see right through from the bilges to the top coats, all the way from the very bottom of the boat, all the way to the top. And that was great to actually follow one project right the way through.
There's too many to talk about. Tools and materials.
Chainsaw.
The bandsaw.
The electric planer.
Planes. The fane tool. My chisels. A power plane.
Sandpaper, sanding blocks. But also we tend to make our own as finishers because the boats are not square things with like square sanding blocks.
Lassiette is what we lovingly refer to as a floating corridor. So she is incredibly narrow, which means when you're working, you haven't got a lot of space.
In a boat, kind of can be upside down. You've got curves, you've got compound angles. So the boat is a challenge in itself.
You're always working with your hips at 90 degrees to your shoulders and you're bent over. So it can be quite an uncomfortable place to be.
There's challenges with everything all of the time. Boats often lose shape. That's a big one. When you're building boats, you're creating curves in empty spaces. You've got to try and keep as many reference points in the empty space so that it all lines up. That's always the biggest issue with any project.
And then the rudder had to be rebuilt, and the other shipwrights are busy with the rest of the boat. So I'm building the rudder, but I'm also in charge of these trainees. And when you train people, you just have to also calculate that you don't get as much work done as a shipwright. So it's going to be a give and take in this project.
I've been here nearly a year and a half now. So now when I start to approach a job, the challenges are still there, but they're different because I know more of what I need to do.
What do I love about it? A lot of things.
Everything.
I think What I love most is just working with other people and the sort of people that boat building attracts. Everyone at the yard's really easygoing and really easy to get on with. We have quite a lot of fun, probably a bit too much fun, probably more than we should.
And the oldest boat that I worked on was built in 1888, and that will outlive me by a long way. So what we're doing is we're preserving history and we're helping so many of these historic boats live on for future generations, and that's quite satisfying.
Well, it keeps the stories alive as well. Like when I rebuilt that one, the amount of people that send you pictures of their family holiday in the 1940s on it, and just lovely. Like, it keeps all those family connections alive and all the grandchildren remember, and then they all come down to see it launch, and it just, I don't know, it connects all those generations of people, doesn't it? I like it.
And in previous roles, I've been very much at the end of a phone or on a keyboard, sat stationary.
I love the physicality. I love that I'm always moving. I love that I don't have a desk, that I don't have email.
I love being able to move around rather than seeing work and outside of work separately. I love the fact that it is my life rather than separate.
I'm attracted to boatbuilding because it's not just three-dimensional. It's kind of curved. It's not square like a house normally is. And that's more challenging, but it's also more beautiful. And you've got to have an eye for lines and for beauty.
It's really not as scary as you might think it is going into it.
So it's always been the way that if you don't see it, you don't do it.
The perception of working in the industry, I think, needs to change.
If you're visible and you wave the flag, you'll actually always encourage people to come through the newer generations, and you show them that this is a viable career path.
There needs to be more information out there available so that it's not seen as a male world.
And you just learn such amazing skills that you can use in everyday life.
Yeah, I would say if this interests you, just go for it and get some experience, walk into a boatyard, ask if you can work. Boatbuilding can also set you up to do loads of other things. It can lead to architecture, it can lead to building other things, it can lead to you setting up a company and actually earning more money with your companies.
And I would say that it's so fucking worth it. Just stick at it.
Yeah, it's for everybody. I often get asked about, you know, being a woman in boat building. I always said when I was training at college, I don't feel like it's any different than if I'm a guy. No, nobody treated me at college any differently.
Boat building is for absolutely everybody.
This is the age. This is the time to do it. Hopefully there will be a time when in this yard there will be as many women building boats as there are guys.
However you think, however you feel, whatever you've done, go for it, because, you know, the world's yours.